process of discipleship like we've been talking about. We have faith walkers, and just imagine, what would it be like if the things that you learned here this week, if over the summer, once you've kind of gotten used to the things, tried them out, and forgotten some things, to just be reminded of everything again. And then, not just to be reminded, you'll be able to go out and practice those things with a couple hundred of your peers. And that's really the vision of Life Train.
Is it for this group, high school, college?
It's for high school, but also college. We want to be part of a whole flow, so we have programs like LINK for college students. We want to be able to have our high school students come through Life Training. Then we have the Unleashed track, which Tom can tell you a little bit about. And then we have LINK. So ideally, when you get to college, you'd be going to something like LINK or one of those summer projects. But if you can't commit the whole summer and you're in college, then you can still come to Life Training and still grow, still have that fellowship.
Okay, so what we talked about, the HSLT track and the Unleashed track work together. The same week, we do some activities together, but the Unleashed is the time that I spend with high school graduates and college, and we have a more intense time, more time together, where we look at some of the challenges we face in college and some of the apologetic issues we have, and our time is just far more intense in terms of actually meeting together and talking together and so on. And the HS Life Leadership Training for more of the undergrad high school, high schoolers undergrad, the underclassmen in high school. And so what do they do?
At the Life Training, the regular track, you'll get a lot of awesome worship like we've had up here. You'll get a lot of the Faith Walker speakers will be there, even some of the, like Thomas Lemus, he'll be there, and some folks speaking, and you'll hear a lot of these truths, but then you'll get to go out and practice them. And that's what's really cool, is that you get time to practice praying for the lost, praying together. You get time to be trained in how to go out and evangelize and share your faith boldly and confidently, and then go practice it somewhere where you don't really know a lot of people, and which is really nice because you can kind of go make your mistakes, kind of get your jitters out, and then just see really God break through some things like that.
That's good. In evangelism, you've got to be like those guys carrying the ark and step your foot in the water sometime. I was reading, was it in Herschel's book? I read, yes, Herschel's pamphlet that he handed out last, that I wanted, that we ran out of talking about. But he made the comment, we rarely share the gospel accidentally or spontaneously. It almost always has to be somewhat planned. That's what HSLT helps us do, is to plan some evangelism, to get our feet wet, to get some training, to practice, to learn in an environment where you're kind of around people you don't regularly see, i.e. Wilmington, North Carolina. And you can try some things and prepare yourself to be better when you come back. Anything else you want to add?
Yes. We are having a lunch roundtable discussion after this. If you are a high school student, I highly encourage you to come to that. If you're a college student and you don't think you'll be able to do kind of the summer-long project, or if you're an adult volunteer, if you're older, especially if you're a parent and you have students that may be wanting to come, I encourage you to come to this time and learn about what Life Training is going to be about. We're going to explain why you want to come to it, some of the things, a little more detail about what we're going to be doing there. We'll also have a couple people that went to Life Training last year who'll explain some of the things that they've seen in their life over the last few months and how it's changed them. So come out to that. Also, if you're a leader of one of these churches that's coming, we're going to give you some materials there, so don't miss out on that or you'll miss your materials.
Okay, so that's going to be in Spillman, right behind here at 12:30. So you're going to be released in just a second to go to the front of the line, eat your food, and get back here in half an hour, okay? Thank you. I've got a couple of announcements. And I do want to stress a little bit about